Mr. Roy, firstly, thanks for sparing this time. Important day, busy day for you.
Every day is busy day.
Let me start by asking you, finally you had a one-on-one interaction with SEBI official for the first time, because it's always been through the court that the battle has been going on. Where are things after this meeting? Are they do they stand at the same place where it was, say, before this meeting, or would things move forward going from here?
No, this is not the first time. Even 2 months back, I had gone there and I met a team of SEBI with one of the executive director. But yes, today another person was there. Actually, we had already submitted our affidavit of our assets. So the one question was there that, do you want to add anything to this affidavit? I said no. Then said that, have you brought the original, documents of your property, etc. I said, you can see that my immovable property is nil, so I don't have anything of that sort. Then they asked me a question that, you want to say something? I'm like, yes, I want to say something. I said, my grave concern is that you are not taking any initiative to plan and make repayments to the remaining investors. I said, you are going for everything against us to get more money, etc., etc. But parallelly, we request you, please take initiative that repayment may start of that five, for which we have paid you 5,000 crores of rupees. And verification has also not started. And unless verification started, then how can you satisfy the concern of Honorable Supreme Court, whether it's fictitious account or not? So, and after that only, we can get refund from you out of 5,000 crores.
So, but if I could ask you, SEBI has said to the Supreme Court that the letters that they sent, hardly 1% people accepted, and rest of majority of the letters came back. So on that, what is the way going forward in this sort of situation?
I really is amusing that anybody and everyone should understand they are small investors. They have already got the repayment before 31st August, before the judgment came. Why should they reply? Why should they spend 5 rupees or 2 rupees or 10 rupees? Why should they reply? They are the investors of 1,000, 5,000, 10,000 rupees. And they don't want to come into these hassles. And why should they reply? They have got the repayment. That's the reason they have not replied. But we are repeatedly requesting SEBI, please give the list, let us see, let us contact, and it is as per the Honorable Supreme Court direction that if there is anything of that sort, you should contact SARA first. And they are not contacting us. They are not giving us the list. It is all creation of problem for us, that's all. It's all tricky things they are doing.
So the other aspect that everyone wants to know is, you have claimed that you have deposited 5,120 crores with SEBI, which would take care of the whole of the repayment, and rather you should be refunded like whatever is left over. But the question again comes, what happens to the 20,000 crores which SEBI says that you are going to deposit with them in January and February of this year?
The point is, the judgment came on 31st August 2012. All remaining repayments were made before that. Where from we can get the money out of it then? Either we have to go to the investors and say, pay back. What can happen under the circumstances? One has to understand. The payment has not made after the judgment. So all the payments were done before that.
So you are saying that you are already refunded close to 20,000 crores plus?
Yes. Rather, we are not to repay 5,000 also. It is excess amount. It is much less than, should be much less than that. And all remaining payments have been made before the judgment came.
So quickly, if I could ask you now, what is the way forward in this? SEBI also has filed a couple of contempt petitions in the Supreme Court.
They want to arrest me also. They want to take my passport also. But please convey SEBI, even they want to send me out of India, I will not go.
So having said that, today also there were other directors of the two companies who were present. Now, have they submitted the requirement of what SEBI were asking for, of their personal details?
Yes, all details they have sent, all income tax returns, everything they have submitted.
So finally, if I could ask you, the general feeling is that maybe your concerns are right, what you are saying is right, but the open battle that we are seeing between Sahara Group and market regulator, at the end of the day, it's the institution, it's the regulator, constitutionally appointed regulator. Is there still a way that Sahara can sit across the table and sort out things with SEBI?
As a responsible citizen, believe me, even I am not happy about it, a regulator of that stature. And we are coming out with such words and such sentences, etc. Even as a citizen, I am not happy about it. But we are pushed to the wall. We have to. Now, the solution can take place in 24 hours. Not more than that. I have sent this request to SEBI. I have sent this request to government. You have to understand the truth of the situation. SEBI and Sahara together should go to Supreme Court and should present that this is the situation, give us so much time, because everything is in the interest of the investors. So if everything is in the interest of the investors, let us talk, think, work for investors first. Let us go to them.